Hi friends, let's have a quick overview of this elective course of MSc Part 2 Microbiology of SBPU Pune. The course title MBTE 32 Bioremediation and Biomass Utilization, an elective course for molecular biology. Now this bioremediation, as the name suggests, like cleaning the environment with the help of biological entities, here we'll be specifically talking about the microbial bioremediation. So here we'll be talking about something about cleaning up the environment. The amount of pollutants we know is huge and is varied, and only one group of organisms which can help us in doing this or cleaning this planet is our microbes. So let us have an overview of this microbial bioremediation. We'll be talking about the microbial degradation of xenobiotics, right? We know the chemical substances which are found within the organisms, but these are not naturally produced, or neither they are expected to be present there. Such particular compounds, they are called as xenobiotics. They may arise from various drugs or medication. They may be pesticides. They may be various chemicals. They are something which are not being degraded very easily and pose a great threat to humanity at large. So these particular xenobiotic compounds, they are being degraded with the help of these microbes. We'll have an overview of that. We'll then go for degradation of some specific compounds like camphor, octane, xylene, naphthalene, and we'll have an overview of the degradation pathway of these compounds. Not only that, we'll go for how these pathways, these biodegradative pathways, they are engineered. So we'll have an overview of the engineered biodegradative pathways of these compounds. I repeat, of camphor, octane, xylene and naphthalene. Then we'll look around what are these aromatic compounds doing out there. Now we know that there are various microbes which are able to degrade these aromatic compounds. Naturally, there are many organisms which are degrading these aromatic compounds, but to enhance the activity, we are altering their genes, we are manipulating them. So we'll have a look towards the manipulation by plasmid transfer or manipulation by gene alteration for aromatic compound degradation by these microbes, so that we can get rid of these large amounts of aromatic compounds in our environment. The next section is about the biomass utilization. We'll go for studying the utilization of these two biomolecules, that is the starch and the cellulose, the complex polysaccharide, the monomeric unit of glucose making them. We'll go for isolation of prokaryotic and eukaryotic cellulase genes, right? We know that cellulose is being degraded by cellulase. To work at the molecular level, we'll go for isolation of both these prokaryotic as well as eukaryotic cellulase gene, manipulation of this cellulase gene, and what are the various advantages which we get after using the Zymomonas mobilis, right? The organism very famous for production of this cellulase. We'll go for what are its advantages. We'll then go for production of alcohol, fructose and silage, and what are the advantages of producing this alcohol, fructose and silage. We'll not only stop there, but we'll see how and like with time scale what improvements have been made in the process of formation of alcohol. Like since many years back we have been producing alcohol, but what improvisation we have made in the production of this alcohol, what improvements we have made in the production of this fructose by using these microbes. We'll go for how this went into the commercialization. So we'll have a look towards the commercial production of alcohol and fructose. With this, we'll end the theory course or the theory part of this particular optional course. The practical section, that is MBPE 32, bioremediation and biomass utilization. We'll go for the first section, that is bioremediation. We'll try to understand the degradation of paranitrophenol compounds, right? So degradation of paranitrophenol using the famous Pseudomonas putida. We'll then go for this plastic, like we know that is a major challenge to the world at large. So we'll go for low density plastic or bioplastic degradation by using the bacterial isolates. We'll understand the process of DNA fingerprinting technique. We may not actually like go and perform or do hands-on on it, but we'll have a demonstration of the entire process of DNA fingerprinting, which finds a wide application in the today's world of molecular biology. Then we'll go to the next section, that is biomass utilization. We'll go how we are trying to sort out the energy crisis which the world is facing. So we'll go for biodiesel production by using these microalgae. So how we can use these microalgae and produce the biodiesel from these microalgae. Similarly, will be going for isolation of bioemulsifier producing organisms for the degradation of aromatic compounds. We know that these aromatic compounds very difficult to degrade, very difficult to solubilize, for which we need bioemulsifiers. Earlier very chemicals were used, now to achieving the goals of sustainable development, we really need to focus on this bioremediation and biomass utilization. So we'll be going for isolation of bioemulsifier, which will help us to emulsify these aromatic compounds and how that is useful in degradation of these aromatic compounds. Stay tuned with us for more such content and more such insights into microbiology. Thank you from me, Professor Girish Kukreja here. Thank you.